Hey everyone, welcome to my 10 minute abs Pilates inspired. So for this 10 minute workout, we're going to do 10 different exercises and each one is going to be 40 seconds long. So we'll have 20 seconds rest then in between each one. So the first 5 exercises we're going to do lying down on the mat, and then the last 5 we're going to do in a plank based position. So it'll be different variations. So we're going to start by coming down onto our mat into a lying position. So we're going to begin by taking both hands behind the head. Head and shoulders come up from the mat, and then we lift both legs to a tabletop position. So the first exercise, before I start the timer, I'm going to be moving the left leg down above the mat and back up, following with the right. But what's really important is my lower back stays pressed into the mat at all times. So that's where we're really getting that maximal core engagement. So the first 5 exercises are going to start in this position, but they'll have slight variation. So I'm going to get the timer ready to go. And off we go with the first exercise, 40 seconds. Drawing that tummy in, lower back pressed into the mat, and alternating legs left and right. Coming down and up. If you find your lower back is lifting, just come halfway down with that leg or to whatever height you can control it. So it's really important that you do it correctly just to get the most out of the exercise. Nice deep breaths. And hug both knees into your chest, okay? So this will be our recovery position, hugging the knees into your chest and just rocking side to side nice and gently. Before the timer goes off again, I'm gonna show you the next one. So we're gonna be bringing opposite knee to elbow, but again, we're doing it so slowly. Off we go. So this is our bicycle crunch with the lower back pressed into the mat all the time. And notice how each time that knee comes in, it doesn't come in over the hip, so we're not bringing it right in to the chest. Again, that's allowing us really engage those deeper abdominal muscles, and that's what Pilates really focuses on. It's engaging those core muscles correctly while supporting the back. So again, if you need to pair this exercise back, just bring the legs halfway down. So I'll do a couple of reps, modified, so we're not coming all the way down above the mat. And rest. Excellent. 2 down. So the next exercise is going to progress on a little bit. Again, starting in our tabletop position, I'll just demonstrate. We're bringing the legs down. Touch the mat if you can. And come back up. Again, you need to go halfway down for this one, then do. I always find this one quite tough. Really imprinting that lower back into the mat. That needs to stay pressed right down to really get the most out of this. And don't forget to breathe. So by slowing the movements down with these exercises, we're taking the momentum out of it. So we're really focusing on engaging properly and getting our muscles to do all the work instead of just that swinging motion taking over. Deep breaths, nearly there. And hug your knees to your chest, rock side to side, excellent. So our second last one here, we're gonna be alternating legs, bringing them down straight above the mat. And again, keeping that lower back glued into the mat as you bring that leg down. And to really get the most out of this one as well, we're doing it really, really slowly. And coming back up. So you should really be feeling the burn with these exercises, especially if you're doing them correctly. One thing you shouldn't be feeling is any pain in the lower back, because if that back is really, really pressed into the mat, it's fully supported. It's when it starts to lift off that it can start to give out a little bit, because it is being put under pressure if we're not engaging the core and letting that back lift up. Okay, so our last one is definitely the most challenging. We're alternating the legs coming all the way down from the straight position. Down and up. This is really good for the hips as well. And if you do find that your hamstrings are really tight and you can't straighten out your legs, don't worry, just keep a little bend at the knees. And again, the hardest part is when the leg is just above the mat. So if you're finding it really tough, just come halfway down. Excellent, hug the knees into your chest. Okay, so we're getting up now. Our next five exercises, we're going to be in a plank position. So before the timer goes off, our plank, we need a really nice straight line at the body and our wrists are under our shoulders all the time. Okay, so get ready. We're just holding our plank for this one. So we're squeezing the glutes and you're drawing the tummy in. So it's almost like you're trying to hold something in. So that's really getting our core engagement. We definitely don't want the hips up. We definitely don't want them down here. We want them right in the middle, tucking the tailbone under and drawing the tummy in towards the lower back. Nearly there. Deep breaths. This is really good for the arms as well, these plank-based exercises. Nearly there. 3, 2, 1. Okay, our recovery position now is one knee down, follow with the other. Sit the bum back onto our heels. So you can come into this position after each of the planks that we do. Our next one is going to be on our forearms. And we're going to rock forward and back in a sawing movement. So I'm going to rock back and forward. Back and forward. So my face is almost coming over the wrists as opposed to over the elbows. So I'm moving forward and back. So think of sawing, like that forward back motion. But the hips shouldn't be moving up and down. It's just forward and back. And still drawing the tummy in, squeezing the glutes. One knee down, follow with the other, and sit the bum back onto your heels. Excellent. Okay, so I'm going to come up and demonstrate the next one. We're back up on our wrists. We're going to be taking the left leg up into the air. And we're exhaling in, bringing in towards the chest, and inhaling out. But my hips don't move up or down. Exhale in, inhale out. So this is quite challenging to really stay steady through your center as we're moving that left leg in and out. And you'll feel a bit of pressure at that right leg as well. So while the focus here is on our core, we really are getting whole body workout with this one. My arms are even starting to shake. Nearly there. And back to your plank drop. One knee down, follow with the other. And sit the bum back onto your heels. This is a really nice recovery position. It's a really good stretch all the way from the hips right up through the arms. So especially if you have stiffness in the back, this is a lovely stretch to do. Getting ready, we're going to repeat that last exercise with the right leg. Right leg up. Exhale in. And inhale out. Exhale in. Inhale out. No swinging at the hips. Inhale out. Exhale in. Inhale out. Exhale in. Inhale out. Exhale in. Inhale out. That's it. Nice and strong through those arms. Drawing the tummy in, squeezing the glutes. Back down, sitting the bum back onto your heels. Nearly there. last one, we're going to be on our forearms. Extend the legs back. We're going to take the left leg up, hold and down. Right leg up, hold and down. So stay with me, left leg up, hold and down. Hips stay really level, right leg up, hold and down. Left leg up, hold, lengthen out and down. Right leg up, hold and down. Left leg up, hold and down. Draw the tummy and squeeze the glutes. Right leg up, hold, down. Drop one knee down, follow with the other. Finish in your recovery position. And just as we're here, we're going to get a stretch along the side of the torso. Walk both hands over towards the left. Walk both hands over towards the right. Nice and easy, opening up along the side of the body. And come back to center. And come back up. And you're done. Great work, everybody. I hope you enjoyed that 10-minute Pilates-based abs. If you liked it, subscribe to my channel, Aoife Hannan. Thank you.